My name's Anna Falls, and I am a junior at Lenoir Ryan University. My story starts with the fact that I'm a work in progress. The Lord worked not just once in my life, but several times to bring me closer and closer to Him. The very first time I ever saw the Lord work in my life was when I was really young. I was 7, and my grandfather was really sick. And the Lord just allowed me to come to terms with the fact that he was going to pass away soon. But he also revealed to me that my family was going to have a really hard time dealing with this. So at the age of 7, I just began to seek and pray that the Lord would just allow it to be me and my grandmother there. That when he passed, everyone else wouldn't be there and would have time to process. So I began a childlike prayer that kind of sounded something like, Lord, if you're there, like, you really care about me, then just allow it to be just me and my grandmother on that day. And it was. A year later, I had prayed this prayer countless times, and my childlike heart just really got to see the Lord move in that. My grandfather passed away, and it was just me and my grandmother in that moment of panic, and then everyone else just was able to come along later and really process that. I was really thankful for that, and about 2 months later, I decided that I wanted the Lord to be a part of my life. If he cared as much to control the circumstances around my grandfather's death, then he must have cared enough to just really want me in my life and to be a part of my life. So I talked to my mom, and she said that was really great and that the Lord did want to be a part of my life, but that there were some problems with that. You see, even at the age of 7, I was doing bad things. I had imperfections in my heart, and the Lord had a perfect standard because he is perfect and holy. I was really concerned at this point. I wanted to know, like, how I could get rid of these imperfections and what I could do, and my mom just let me know that there was nothing I could do, but that God had already done everything for me. He sent his son Jesus, his only son, to die on the cross for our sins. That just looks like Jesus came and he walked around and he was God and man, and then he was crucified on a cross. But because he lived a perfect life without sin, which is something I could never do, then his blood that was shed just covers all of my imperfections and allows the Lord to see me as holy and perfect, therefore I can meet his standard. So my mom explained all of this to me and I was able to grasp it. And so it was on that day that the Lord really just took hold of my heart, and I like to say he became the savior of my life. It wasn't until later, in my high school days, that I met a girl who loved the Lord and was living for him. She had some really hard circumstances in her life, a story that involves just terrible things to be done to a girl, and yet she could still love the Lord through her life, and I didn't understand that. So I got a chance to talk with her and just like work through her problems and just look at them, and she let me know that the Lord loved her and that she was living a life that involved like digging into the scripture and going on mission trips and just really listening and acting upon the will of God. And I really desired that. So it was then that the Lord became the Lord of my life. And I allowed my decisions to be just controlled by him. And it was a really great day. I'm still not perfect, and the Lord's still working in me. But like I said, I'm a work in progress, and he's never going to leave, and he's never going to fail me.